Let's talk about another one of my favorite subtraction strategies, the open number line method. So let's use the subtraction expression of 213 minus 57. With the open number line strategy, what I'm going to do is this time I'm going to start at the minuend. So I'm going to start over here at 213, and I need to subtract 57. So if you want to think of it this way, I'm going to be hopping back 57. Again, I want to think about my friendly numbers, right? If I think about 213 even minus 50, I'm not going to be able to do that in my head. So I'm going to think about what are some easy things I can subtract, but then I'm also keeping in mind this 57 as well, right? Because when I subtract it, I don't want to subtract something that is really odd that I can't do in my head. Remember, we're focusing on mental math subtraction at this point. So something you might see a student do is just to subtract by 10. I know how to subtract 10. So I'm going to start with that. So I'm going to subtract 10, and now I know that 213 minus 10 is going to give me 203. So one idea might be to keep subtracting 10, and you might have a student that does that, which is great. This is the beauty of the open number line strategy. We have many different options. Another idea might be just to get to 200, because I know once I get to 200, then I'm at a really friendly number and I can subtract some larger numbers at that point. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that and just subtract 3. Notice that my hops are not really proportionate. That's okay, I'm all right with that. The key is that I'm sticking to my number line and I'm thinking about going in this direction. Okay, so now I'm at 200. I know I need to subtract 57, so right now I'm at 13. I know that I'm not close to 57 yet, so I'm thinking about how I can do that. I can actually subtract 40 from 100 because, again, I know my combination is to 10, so I know that 4 and 6 is 10, therefore I know 40 and 60 is 100. Therefore, I know that 140 and 60 would give me 200. So I'm gonna subtract 40. All right, so now I'm paying attention to my numbers up here, and I can see that I have 40, 50, 53. I am still 4 away from subtracting that 57. So now I'm just gonna hop 4 backwards. So 160 minus 4, again, if I know my combinations to 10, I know that that would give me 156. Remember, with the open number line strategy, students are going to do this several different ways. Let me show you another way that we could demonstrate this with 213 minus 57. You might have a student that says, I want to get to 210 because I'm really comfortable, again, once I get to that friendlier number first. So maybe I'm going to start by subtracting 3. I could do that. That's going to leave me at 210. Then maybe I subtract 10, or even maybe you have a student that's feeling comfortable with even subtracting 20. I could do that as well. I know that 210 minus 20 would give me 190. Now I could go ahead and just subtract 30 because, again, I'm feeling really comfortable because this ends in a zero. So I'm going to subtract 30. I get 160. Now I'm noticing up here that I'm at 30 and 20 is 50, 53. So as of right now, I've subtracted 53. Again, I need to get to 57. I could go ahead and subtract 4. Now maybe a student doesn't know what 160 minus 4 is. So the beauty of this is they could subtract by 1. So they could go 159, 158, 157, 156. That also is always a possibility. The thing I love about this strategy is it really allows students to move and make progress with where they're at in their subtraction facts, even if, you know, they are maybe struggling a little bit more or they're really a little bit more advanced and able to do some of that mental math in their head. Sometimes I'll have students that ask me, so what's the difference between the open number line strategy and the add up strategy, right? Here's the main difference. In the open number line strategy, notice that I was starting with the minuend and I was subtracting backwards, right? I was actually subtracting and moving left on the number line. In the add up strategy, I'm starting with the subtrahend and I'm adding up until I get to that minuend. Another thing I want to tell you is that sometimes I get students that will do math on the side. Here's what I mean. They're using the open number line strategy, right? And they're like, okay, I'm at 213 and I know I need to subtract 57. And they'll do something like this. Well, 213, what if I took away 42? If I have to do any math, I'm working too hard. I need you to be lazier. things you never thought your teacher would say to you. So with your subtraction strategies, any of them, you shouldn't have to do any regrouping, any side math. These should all be mental math strategies or mental math facts that you're comfortable with. And sometimes with students, we even remind them of that. Like, hey, tell me what subtracting 10 would give us. Tell me what subtracting 100 would give us. What facts can you use? So we really want to play on their prior knowledge of their subtraction facts, not doing any of this side math. Hopefully, you now have a better idea of how to use the open number line strategy for subtraction and how that relates to the add up strategy as well.